American Green. Right, howdy, welcome back. This part of your trip is very basic, but there will be a quick stop at Albert Canyon to pick up some stuff. After the small consist ahead clears, you may need to request a pass signal before you get going. One thing I really like, I haven't got the Xbox controller plugged in, so I can't do cinematics. One thing I really like about RBjet scenarios is at the end, of the, there's usually something wrong with the cow and the guy in the van. And then in the beginning of the next scenario, it's all fixed. Because in last night, in Leaving Revelstoke Part 1, at the end, the cow is in the back of the truck. And in one of the ones of Wenatchee, the cow was on the roof and the guy was sitting there looking at it going, whoa, what? Here he comes. Let's turn the lights off, not blind the poor fella. Are we pink pigging tonight? We are indeed pink pigging, continuing our explorations of Iceland. The frozen food aisle. Oh, he is going to go eventually. Yeah, we need to cross over and we're just waiting for him to clear the line. Saying request to pass approved. Is it hard to run the north end of New York, New Haven? Then, how do you mean, Mr. Tranko? Well, I thought that was relatively straightforward. How long is this route, Shazam? Really, really long. So you've got Revelstoke here, and you make your way all the way up. You've got the big tunnels here, round here. You eventually get to Golden at the bottom, so effectively you're doing this to get to Golden, and then you carry on along the eastern line via the spiral tunnels on the Kicking Horse Pass before you eventually get down here to Eldon. There's Revelstoke to Eldon, which is effectively the Kicking Horse Pass, and I can't remember what the western side is called. It's essentially, I think it's the mountain sub. It's almost all of the mountain sub, the Canadian Pacific Mountain Subdivision. Oh, performance-wise? No, I wouldn't have thought so. Shazam, yeah, it is good. It comes with a selection of freight cars, including some unique to Canada. It's, you know, it's got a selection of the... So like the canned potash is unique to Canada, and it's also got the Canadian grain car, which is, unlike being just a hopper, this one is a completely unique type to Canada. And then there are reskins and various other freight cars which are just done for this this pack, plus the Canadian Pacific ES44. Cracking route, it really is. One thing you do need to do is to run it with the scenery density set to maximum. If it's set anything below that, what can happen is some of the scenery that's underpinning the track disappears, like bridges or verges, things like that. Some of those disappear. If you run it at full scenery quality, sorry, scenery density, then they're all there. Coming up on 35. You don't think my headlights? No, they're not, because I turned them off for the other train and then forgot to put back on again. That's why I run them, Shazin, so that you can see everything and make your own mind up what you want to see. I don't want to recommend things. I love to put what? Dispatch, stop! How does your big does your PC need to be for full spec? I mean, I'm running it on a really top-end machine, and even then, some parts of it won't run properly. It won't run full. You know, you can't. You're never going to get always get 60 FPS minimum. Fundamentally, train sim is something like 9 years old. Although it's been extended and enhanced and improved, it's, the core engine is 9 years old, which means it's not taking full advantage of the latest hardware. The key things you want to do is have a reasonably good CPU, lots of gigahertz, not lots of cores, because the game won't run lots of won't make use of lots of cores. It's fundamentally single core. The best graphics card you can give it, pretty much. I mean, I'm running a 980 Ti because it'll do things like SSAA, the super sample screen, super sampled anti-aliasing, which is all done on the graphics card. If you've got a really meaty graphics card, then you can crank up that setting and get stunning high def images out of it with the alias or the anti-aliasing quality. One of the other key things you want to put in there is an SSD, and I'd pretty much get the fastest hard drive you can buy, because the game reads an awful lot of data off of the disk, and in doing so, if you've got a smaller machine, then it's a slower hard drive, it's going to be really stuttery. Clayton Hodge, how much does it cost? Well, quite a bit. The rail driver is about £200 on its own, just this bit. Then there's the button, there's a foot pedal underneath that I'm not using at the moment. All of these SciTech flight instrument panels, you can get them on Amazon. This is a SciTech backlit information panel. Officially, none of this stuff works with the game. I've just made it work with the game. That's the core of this lot, and then track IR, which is that bit that makes the camera pan. Good night, Hectic Karma. Gubby Freak. Matt is switching to 64 bits. Very expensive. It's not so much about expensive switching to 64 bits, although yes, the answer is it is. It's actually there's a lot of technical issues about whether or not it can go to 64 bits. Because the game is not just a blob of code, it also requires a number of external libraries that do various functions. And if any of those can't be available in 64-bit versions, because again, they're quite old, then that stops the whole thing from going to 64-bit potentially, or without replacing the library or some other horrible bridging system. So there's lots of complexity. It's just easier to start again, and that's the whole point of the Unreal Engine. How to use a green screen, Robloxian. I don't know how much this one costs, because it came basically free and with my video editing software. How to use it? It's dead easy. In OBS, you just switch on with a chroma key and then point to the pixel that's got the right colour for it. It samples it and then wipes it all out, everything that's like that. So, and it doesn't have to be green. You can get chroma blue, chroma green. Cab looks exactly like the one you did playing on Sherman Hill. Is it a reskin? Yeah, it's a reskin, but it's got new physics. This has got different physics, different braking. Actually, it'd be older than the one in Sherman Hill, because Sherman Hill was an updated one after this. This one had the second generation of the North American braking system on it, so it behaves more realistically. Sherman Hill then took it another step further and had a complete rewrite again on that, which was even better. So this has got much better braking than the default, and it was the first one that confused everybody, and everyone said, oh, the brakes are broken, it doesn't work. Yeah, actually, stopping a 2-mile long train turns out takes a long time. Flying Scotsman. GTX 970 is fine. It's a good card. It's what I use on my desktop at work. What's the best SSD? If you can afford it, I would go for what they call an M2 PCI Express. They're much more expensive, but they're the best. Failing that, even just the 6 gigabit per second SSDs are good. Anything's better than a mechanical hard drive. To find out what's up with my TS last week, where it kept stuttering. No, I'm just making sure I reboot before each stream now, because that seems to fix it. Make your own green screen. It's Apple green. It was €30. In total, only my lights can get them better. Lord BT50, it's not uncommon for CP Real to have a mile and a half long train with one local in the lead, one in the middle, one in the rear. The common ones actually for this route are actually what they call a 2-1-1. Two at the front, one in the middle, one in the rear, all ES44ACs, GEVOs. They can be a lot longer, into 2+ miles long. I think it's something like 230 cars. Windows 10 anniversary's played havoc with a lot of PCs. Yeah, I know, they've done something, haven't they? I still need to fix the camera, but it's working okay, so I just need to improve it. Yeah, the key thing with the green screen is that whatever, you can pick any colour you like. It's just make sure that the things that you want to keep are not that colour. So if you're using a green screen, don't wear a green shirt. Sounds obvious, but seriously, you will forget. We have the high ball. Oh, got a grain train heading the other way. One of the key things with a green screen is to make sure it's completely flat and you don't have shadows all over it. You know, if it's wrinkled, you can get shadows in there. And then with OBS, what you can do is, having clicked on a pixel to get a green, you can then widen the range out so that it's sort of, if it's within this tolerance of green, then it'll work. But the more you do that, then you'll find other things start getting captured as well. So it's a finding a right trade-off, which is why the chroma green and chroma blue are so interesting, because they are bright, unique colours that are just unlikely to appear anywhere else. I tried using a green. I loaned my green screen to something my wife was chaperoning so that they could do photographs, and I tried to make a green screen out of a sheet. It just didn't work. RS Gaming has just posted links to his YouTube and his Twitch. Don't forget to go and give him a bookmark, and he runs a whole bunch of different stuff. He's a friend of mine and a good streamer. He's just getting started. International drivers have to keep the foot on the pedal in the cab. Yeah, we've got a similar thing called a DSD, driver safety device. And then what happens is every 60 seconds the alarm goes off and they have to release the pedal and put it back down again. which I think is similar how that works. In these, on these trains, it's the yellow button. This one, the alerter reset, but this train doesn't have the alerter implemented. What are the GeoPCDX and DCSV files in the engine folder? So GeoPCDX is geometry, so it's the 3D shape of an object. There's a TGPCDX, which is the textures, and then there is the DCSV are CSV files, but they're just pattern formatted in a particular way. Do you use these headsets when you move your head, the character move? Yeah, it's called a track IR. It's this thing here. And then there's a camera just up there. Can't find a PCIe M2 SSD client, Scotsman. Like I said, any SSD will do, even the regular 6 gigabit per second ones. Anything is better than a mechanical disk. But don't get a hybrid, one of these SSHD things or they're awful. Hey, Luke Hostad, welcome. Glad you could join us. Thanks for the follow, much appreciated. I'm in a hard drive. Japan Deluxe, is an SSD useful for what would be underpowered PCs? It won't fix all of the problems, like if your frame rate is always low, it won't help. If you get big stutters, then it will help eliminate some of that. Generally speaking, an SSD will generally improve the performance of a machine. But it isn't the magic bullet. It depends what's wrong and what you're trying to do with it. Oh. WT, thanks for all the good content. Way too much to watch at all. Yeah, I know. There's 1,200 or 1,300 videos there now. Freak. Try not to think about it. Thank you very much for the donation, WT. Can I get some GGs for him, please, somebody? Gaming laptop's good enough to run TS. Well, ultimately, in theory, yes, a gaming laptop should be fine. It depends what the spec is, though. A gaming laptop is just a laptop. But if it's got a decent gaming graphics card... The sound of the donation's way too loud. Alright, I'll try and tune that up next time. Throttle back up again. Just around the corner is your pickup on Albert Canyon Siding South. Clear the switch, then reverse and grab the 5 potash empties. Oh, by the way, Fanny, I think your one just came through. That was a donate. I think you did that one via an e-check. Remember, if I've got that correct, that one cleared today. So there you go. Thank you very much for that. And get some GGs for Fanny, please. Right, where's that side? Pop Pop Amal donated, says, completely forgot your birthday, here's a little something. The daily streams you provide us with during the years. Hopefully this is a small something to repay the gaming PC bill. Chat spam. Oh, chat spam. Can I get some Frankazies for Pop Pop Amal, please? Thank you very much, Pop Pop Amal and fam Fanny Schmetter. Am I saying that name even remotely correctly, by the way? So going via that, stopping, and then we're going to back up and get those cars. Fair enough. That consist. Yeah, it's got a bit of everything, doesn't it? Yeah, don't spam too many Frankers, otherwise Moodbot will have words. Potash train going the other way. There's our cars sitting up there. You don't like the Doppler effect on more engines. No, ideally engines are supposed to have a randomizing pitch element, which means they're never always exactly the same. Sometimes it doesn't always work though. And you get a strange effect out of it. Right, let me. I mean, what I'm trying to do is have a look, see if I can reduce the volume of that alert box. High volume alert is okay. Well, we've had a couple of complaints that it scared the pants off people, so... I've turned it down a bit. We'll see where that goes. Francois, what is the significance of the dogs? Because Pop Pop Amel requested the spamming of dogs. Rather than the GGs as we normally do for a donation. think there's a cat in here. Cat may have just fallen somewhere. Fail. But another one in the middle. How many trains are in the middle of that, are there? Oh no, that's probably the one from up there. Look at the back of this train now. You like to see the Cleethorpes to Manchester Airport. Yeah. I quite like the little airport routes, actually. I did research the one up to Manchester Airport. I don't know if it was from Cleethorpes, but certainly around that area. Lady or the other. I don't know. All I heard was a bang behind me. So either the rolling pins come out, or... Lungo 08, thank you for the follow. Much appreciated. Not under there. Kiddies! No. No signs of cats now. They must have decided that they wanted to do something else. As is their right. Right, haul on the brakes. Change that switch. Go and get those five cars. Infinity 13, thank you for the follow. Much appreciated. That bang was a raccoon visiting you. Don't think we have raccoons here. Cats do what cats do. Yeah, cause trouble, Moggy. Cause trouble. Hey, NASCAR. Well, we found the end of that one. Right, let's end this part up at Downey South Truck West. Height maps, if you look on my YouTube channel, Detective Inspector Knee, you'll find that I've done a video on exactly how to do that. And how to get Google Maps working as well, and how to bring markers in from Google as well. Stone looks kind of ominous in there, doesn't it? Like it just landed and there's a giant over there somewhere. I got on Steam code that the game crashing isn't the actual game, but instead it's Steam causing the crash. That's the first time I've heard that. We work for Titan Rail, which we're based in Rotherham. Can you explain why in some scenarios after finishing it you don't get XP and a medal? So are you running in simple controls? If you're running in simple controls you won't get medals and XP. If you are running in expert controls then you should on any scenario which has to be a career scenario and has to be a scenario that was shipped with either the game or a piece of DLC. Anything else won't do it. Now, if it's a piece of if one of the scenarios that comes with a piece of DLC, you're in expert controls and you don't get XP, then the other reason you might not get XP is if you earn 500 points and when you first time you run it, if the second time you run it you earn 450 points, you don't get another 450 points because you've already earned 500. If you get 600 points the next time round, then you'll only get 100 points added to your XP. So there's a maximum of 1000 XP per scenario. But if it's the first time you've run it, it's a career scenario that's supplied by Dovetail on Steam, and you're not in simple controls, and you don't get XP, then you should raise a support ticket. and say exactly what scenario you did, what score you got. Take a screenshot of the screen, actually, would be even better. And then they can look into it and find out why. Hope that helps. Does XP do anything? No, it's just a... XP was intended as a way for people to compare each other. If you reset all bricks progress, your level stays, but you get the XP again. Oh, really? Doesn't your XP go back to zero again? Or does your XP level go stay where it is? It stays where it is, that's it. I'm just going to reset my stats. I just run train spotting scenarios over again. You're going to get a cat, are you, Dean? Awesome, cats are awesome. 2.2 miles to Downing South Track West. Love this route. Really is nice. I really like the Canadian routes in MSTS. So I was really pleased when Jonathan said he was making this one. This one's by Milepost Simulations, the route. Strangely, Jonathan's British, lives in Britain. He's just really fascinated by Canadian railways. BJT, hey, how's it going? Someone gifted you Bus Simulator. All your gold glods, slibbles and bronzes go. No, I don't want to do that. My golds have been hard won. Academy scenarios are the easiest to get XP. Yes, definitely. Milepost Simulations did my Thailand line south as well. They also helped out on Pacific Surfliner. They did quite a bit of work helping the Dovetail team on Pacific Surfliner. And Jonathan did another route before that, British Columbian route, I can't remember what it was called now, which was done before going on Steam. .2% rise here. Not 22%, Chaz, and it's 2.2. South Fraser, that was it. The Fraser line. JTRS, is that train control thing? Yeah, this is called a rail driver. I've got this also, this yellow button, because everyone needs a smacky button. Doesn't work on this loco, but normally it's used for safety system resets. There's a foot pedal down on the floor as well that I bought extra. Raging Adult, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. I do love this red. Why I love red more than I like the yellow or the orange or anything, but this is nice. Alright, there's Downing South up there. When you miss Glod by 1 point, I know. What's the foot thing for? So in the UK, we have a thing called a driver safety device where you have to press and hold the foot pedal down, and every 60 seconds or so an alarm will go off in the cab and you have to release it and repress it again. It's like a vigilance device essentially for the driver. And then in Germany they've got this thing called CIFER, and I use that exactly the same way. Pink. Oh, that pink train. BK4444, thank you for the follow. Much appreciated. Right, the signal marks our endpoint. There you go, look, we've got another bloke with us. Let's see what's happening with the cow this time. This is like Cuneo's mouse. I hope you're all familiar with Cuneo's mouse. Yeah, he's got it in the boot. I'll bring it gently up to the signal and then we can stop. I spotted a pink pig driving down the road yesterday, Dash D. Nice. Come on, get up this hill. Is it the same guy with the same cow? I think so, it's Derek. Yeah, it's Derek. What are you doing with that cow, Derek? That train looks enormous from this view, as it should do. Great job, Leaving Revelstoke Part 3 coming soon. Right, that's that one done. To that one. Last scenario. So going to Ohio Steel 2 now, which is not a route we do very often. But we have a couple of